You're tuned in to Madden 18. Look to take another step towards the Super Bowl. It's the Cowboys going up against the Bears.
All right, Larry, EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. Coming up, an important divisional round matchup in the NFC between the Dallas Cowboys and the Chicago Bears. One of two spots in the NFC title game awaits the winner here as we're underway in the divisional round of the NFL playoffs. Forward to about the 27-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and eight.
Well, he's looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple yards out of it because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. They'll look to throw. And he finds a man with a crossing route. And he is going to feel that one. Knocked down hard right there at the 43. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. Throw here on first down. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. He had a great move, but he'll still be stopped shy of midfield. It's a gain of five, and that'll bring up second down. Here back at the 47. It'll be a loss of one, and it'll be third down. Now that play was doomed right from the start.
They just about ran into every defender on that one, didn't he? It felt like everyone got a piece of that tackle.
Offense faces a third and medium with 6 yards left. To throw here. He's going to look deep down the field. And he can't hang on to it. Nearly picked. He's known for his hands defensively. But instead, it just brings up fourth down. Out now comes the Cowboys punter. As the first drive of the game stalls out, he's on to punt. And he'll get this away into the icy winter air. This is fielded in the seven. They'll net only 35 here following a 43-yard boot, 8-yard return. And it'll be first and 10 Bears from deep in their own territory. There at all. He's up only to about the 16-yard line. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it second and nine.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run. Second down following the run.
Here we go now. Good.
They'll look to throw. Left side, it's complete. And he'll be out of bounds right at the 35. They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains. Three. And to give this time to the tailback. And this defense not giving him anything there. Maybe a yard up to the 36.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again. Go play action and hit them over the top.
And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. And he's across the 40, three extra yards to the 43. That second down run, a big help. The 7 yards leaves him with just a third and three now. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
They'll set up a throw. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
This defense is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
This is away, and a very good kick angled for the sidelines. The offense for the Cowboys now working their way back onto the field. The crowd may be losing just a little bit of the edge after back-to-back punts.
They want some big plays. They want to see some offense. They want to see somebody break away, whether it's through the air or on the ground. Now it'll be interesting to see where the patience is on both sides. Each head coach, can you hang in there and not try and force something that could put your team in some jeopardy?
Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. Give him 7 on the play, and it'll be second down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
Second down now after the pass completion.
Watch it now, Barney, Barney.
They'll run it now out of the gun, and they'll bring him down after just a short pickup. They got 2 of the 3 they needed there. It leaves them with 3rd and just a yard. We haven't seen much from him running the football here in this first quarter.
No, you're right about that. We haven't seen much of him at all so far. They've stacked him up pretty well. But when you're trying to run the football, sometimes you've got to play the long game. Keep handing it to him, and some of those runs that aren't working now, they turn into 6, 7, 8, and maybe more later on.
He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And he's going to have the first down yardage as he's down at about the 30-yard line. He needed a yard, that's what he got, and it's going to earn him a new set of downs. So the offense has it 1st and 10. The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass. Looking to throw. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up 2nd down. And this pass defense, they were sensational in the win last week, and they're looking good here so far in this first quarter.
You know how we often talk about how offenses get locked in, and that runs over multiple games where they're really, you know, in that zone? Defenses can be the exact same way, and I think we're seeing an example of it here.
Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping. A little antsy on the left side of the line.
Yeah, I think they got the guy in the end. I think they got the DN there on that one. And let's face it, he is so amped up, wanting to get a good get off on the snap, jump too quickly.
So 2nd and medium, 2nd and 5 now.
Here we go now. 3-19. 3-19.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Open man left side is Wallace, complete. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive. We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger gain. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
They're going to look to throw. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
So incomplete on first. Let's see what 2nd down has in store. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. And a loose football. Raiders have recovered. They have. And in this very cold night air, how much harder, Charles, is it to hang on to that football?
It's a lot harder, and I know for the most part we think about a ball being slick when there's rain or snow, any type of moisture. But when it's cold and dry
and
like this,
cold.
And it is cold, it's also slick that way because you're not able to really grip it the same way. Your hands are cold, and then the hits seem harder. So, yeah, it's a lot more difficult to hold on to the football, which means you have to emphasize it that much more.
Wind chills right now, 12 degrees. Less than a minute to go here in a scoreless first quarter to this point. They'll run it now out of the gun. Call it a gain of four there, so it sets up a big play here. Third and a yard.
That's a really good job right there. Just kept stringing that play out, pushing further and further towards the sideline. Really good fundamentals by that defense.
He was trying to put his foot in the ground and turn upfield. He just couldn't.
No, they really had a picket fence in front of him. No room to find to get upfield.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And nowhere really to go there. He'll take this up just shy of midfield. Only a yard of the pickup there, and it's going to leave him with a fourth down. And in their own territory, needing only a few inches, they're going to line up to go for this thing on fourth down. Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis back with you as it's Bears football here to begin quarter number two. They are, however, facing a fourth down situation. So in their own territory, but they only need a few inches, so they're going to opt to go for this thing. We'll see. Maybe a surprise pass, a run. What will they do? We're about to find out. Fourth down. They'll try and throw for it here. He's got his tight end on the corner route. It's complete. It's a gain of 15 that time. And that leads to a Chicago first down.
And the game just keeps evolving. Big guys running those corner routes, so difficult to cover.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. Dancing to his left. And some room to maneuver. And avoids the contact by sliding. Nice work to get seven out of that, and it's second down.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
Now a handoff looking right. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
How many times do we say in this game that speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways? In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary, but led to a really nice game.
7 yards on the play, and it'll make it second down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
It's a 10-yard gain there, and it sets him up now first and goal. Leopard! And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Chicago. A great effort there. Taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Bears are in for six. And oh, it's blocked. one seam, and he might go all the way. 20, but he'll get no further as he's brought down within sight of the goal line inside the 20. But all he'll get is knowledge that the extra point is no good.
You and I have not met a coaching staff yet that likes to coach negative situations, you know, even plant that in their head. But you have to work on what happens if you get an extra point blocked, because now they can pick it up and return it for 2 points. Yeah. You have to go over that.
Nice job to get back there and make the tackle, preventing them from getting all the way. First down. Flush to his right. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down.
How about that? One of the so-called little guys putting the pressure on. That was a strong safety. When I was in college, we often called that a lightning blitz.
Now they'll throw here out of the gun. He's going to loft one deep left side, and that's caught inside the 30. Touchdown, Cowboys. A big play there. 63 yards, and the Cowboys are now just an extra point away from moving out in front. Well, you know he can be explosive, and he's ultra explosive there on the fly route.
And you know how many times we've talked to coaches, and we've had to pull him back to us? Well, you know something? When you execute really well, it doesn't matter if they know it's coming or not. But sometimes athleticism beats you as well. He just took off and went. And that's almost like one of your turkey bowl games, isn't it? Just go long, man. I'll hit you. And it worked really well for them.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Bears offense now heading back out onto the field. They'll run it now out of the gun. Oh, a heck of a move.
Man.
And not a whole lot doing there as he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. Here to his running back, and he'll be brought down right around the 37. They get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. I think if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
They'll look to throw now on first down. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up 2nd down.
If you run an out route, it's likely you end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there?
Toe tap.
You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. Gain there. This one goes for 20.
When big runs occur, sometimes there's a sense that things were pretty easy, and that one carried them down inside the 10. But getting into the end zone now, that won't be easy at all, because you're going to face different defenses and not as much real estate to work with. Will they be able to run it?
And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes.
Well, there's still time to rectify this situation because the silver lining, they took a sack on first and goal. But that close to the goal line, that still definitely hurts.
Two minutes to play here in the first half. Back with more NFC playoff action after this. Second and goal to go now. And finding room to work, he's down to the two-yard line. A very valuable nine-yard pickup, and now they're set up a little better here for third and goal. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Bears. A great play there with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Bears are in for six. And he atones for his miss the first time around as this one is up and good to extend their lead. The punter, Kazer, now out to kick it away. This one taken just inside the 10. Now a hit and a loose football. And this is picked up by the Bears. And they will take over at the 26-yard line.
How many times in the course of a game do you talk about momentum plays? And I think we just saw one there.
Absolutely.
Just scored, right?
Just took the lead.
Just took the lead, went downfield, got the ball free again and picked it up. They got a chance to really get the momentum on their side now.
And now they'll try to pile on. Going to give this time to the tailback. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Partner, I think from our experience together, we have learned that most offensive coordinators are going to tell you, if I'm going to run the football on first down, I've got to get at least 4 yards. They got five here. They've got to feel pretty good about that one.
They'll drop the throw. And he will find his man on the outside. And able to get this down inside the 15, either the 13 or 14 before he's out of bounds. Now they'll run it on the toss. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
I like the call. Inside the red zone, running the toss. Why? They want to get to the edges. They want to see if guys who don't normally make a lot of tackles are willing to actually do that. That usually means the guys at the cornerback position.
Back to throw here. Buying time to his left. And he whips that one incomplete there.
You got to be precise with your throws, especially in this situation. You're inside the 10-yard line going into the end zone. But sometimes the emotion, the excitement, sometimes the decisions just aren't made very well because of that.
The Bears on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This will be third and 6. He'll drop to throw. A bullet throw, but incomplete.
Just looking at it from a defensive perspective, when you break the huddle in the red zone, tight end is one of the guys you've got a key on because quarterbacks want the ball in their hands fast in this position, and they want to get it to someone. And in this case, he had the play. They just didn't complete it.
So a good snap, good hold, and that one's right down the middle.
Never in doubt. Just the way you used to hit them, Brandon.
This one taken just inside the 10. And some space here. Accelerating, and off he goes. Touchdown, Cowboys. I know a lot of special teams coaches, they just want to keep it away from him because that's what he can do.
And others have egos that their players can't keep up with. And they say, challenge him. Kick it to him. The way he runs as fast as he is, I wouldn't challenge him at all. I'd do everything possible to keep it away.
He is just a blur when he gets a full head of steam, and he got a full head of steam there. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. And now the Bears coming out as they get ready. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead. But a mistake there, that could change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
He'll get 8 on the scramble there. It'll be 2nd and a couple.
Now, that was not a bad scramble there on first down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable 2nd and short.
He'll look to throw. He's going to fire one deep left sideline, and that one will fall incomplete. Clock here now just under 30 seconds to go in this first half. Now back to throw. He's going to air one out. And that one incomplete. Had some position but couldn't hold on, and it brings up 4th down.
Brandon, it looked like he had his hands on it for a moment, but let's face it, that was going to be a tough catch all the way because of the presence of the defense right there as he was trying to haul it in.
Yeah, nice job to force the incompletion. We'll call that a 43-yard punt, 2 on the return, and control of the football switching hands with very little time remaining until the half. And out now come the Cowboys. And with time quickly fading here in the 2nd quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Got his man complete over the middle. That's Hines. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. Down, he'll drop to throw it. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And incomplete there, almost picked off. That's one you maybe expect your roaming free safety to come up with. But it's 2nd down. And they line up now for what will likely be the last play of the first half. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to be stopped dead in his tracks. Looks to be right around the 40. So we've come upon halftime here in this NFC Divisional Round matchup, as we'll send you down to Orlando where Larry Ridley has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry? So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. Short kick here, fielded about the 17. And he'll have good starting field position as he's up just shy of the 40. So here's the Bears offense now as they get set to start this 3rd quarter. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had the ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
That one, 28 yards on the ground. So the run moves the chains, and here we go on 1st down. They'll set up to throw. Got a man over the middle, and it's complete. Touchdown, Chicago!
As a fan, is there anything prettier than a well-executed post route?
No, it's a thing of beauty, especially when it's done like that for a touchdown.
How about the throw, the catch, and how about the run after to get it to the end zone?
The punter, Kazer, now out to kick it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the 2nd half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half 2.
try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10, kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use, just something to get you off to a quick start.
Throw now on first down. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off around the 41. And he brings it back to right around the 26-yard line.
Well, this is one of the downsides of being a rookie quarterback. You know you're going to get called out about everything you do that goes wrong. Here, maybe he's a little uncertain about where to go with the football. And at this level, uncertainty equals turnovers. And this one winds up being intercepted.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
Now a handoff as they run left side. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. It'll wind up being a loss of two. And that'll make it second and 12. On play action, they'll throw. Finding his safety valve here. That's complete. And he takes this one in for a Bears touchdown. A great effort there. Saving his best for the playoffs with his third touchdown of the game. And the Bears use the short field to their advantage as they cash in for six. And that will make this a 16-point lead. The punter, Kazer, now out to kick it away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Dallas offense now heading back out onto the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six. 6 yards to go here on second down. He'll look to throw. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
And ready for third and six. Complete. He's at the 30, the 20, and he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. A big play there, 71 yards, and the Cowboys cut into that lead. That's the score you felt they had to have here in the third quarter to get back in this game. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Snags it for the pick. And now nothing but green ahead of him. The 30. And he takes it all the way back. It's a pick two, if you will, as head play backfires in a big way. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This is taken near the 13. Now the Bears offense ready to take over again. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Looking left side, it's complete. He's got it. The 15 yards there on the catch and run.
It's a nice completion, a little bit of run after catch as well to create the yardage that they got. But it is so tough to cover that route, the drag route, because they run it at varying speeds. Because the key is to create hesitancy on the defender's part.
Always so empathetic for those DBs, aren't you? The offense lining up first and 10. Time running out here on the play clock. He didn't seem in a rush. I guess they just didn't know where the play clock was.
I think you're right about that because there was no hurried movements there, right? No up-tempo at all. Clock just ran out. I think he was as surprised as maybe his bench was.
Shift together here from the D-line. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's got some space here. 25 yards to pick up there and also a first down.
I know that play went to the left side, and that's what it was designed to do, an outside handoff there. But how about the whole offensive line being involved? Seal the left side where the play was going, where they call play side. But how about on the back side? Just taking care of business to make sure no one can get there and disrupt it.
Is the biggest key the left tackle?
Without a doubt. Control that edge. Get out there. You want that left tackle, or if you bring your tight end over there, either way, control the edge of the line of scrimmage, you got a chance to rumble.
Lucky 56. Here we go now. Oh, he's got a little daylight. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10.
Detroit!
And he'll give it here to his running back. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. Officially, no gain on the play, and it's second down. Switch it up here and look to throw. And he slings one that's incomplete. Well, the numbers have been good in the passing game and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, a little credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football a little bit more in this spot. But they have to feel good about how they've been throwing it overall.
Intercepted. Would have been a huge pick in the end zone, but as it stands, that brings up fourth.
But that was certainly an aggressive call and an aggressive play. Instead of just going for the first down, took the shot in the end zone, went for the touchdown.
And on third down, they said, forget about the sticks. We want six. And his kick here is good. And that will make this now a 15-point advantage. So it goes down as an 8-play drive, and they cap it with the field goal.
Yeah, they were able to pick up a few first downs along the way, but they couldn't keep the momentum going all the way into the end zone.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. And now here come the Cowboys. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
They'll try and start this drive in the air. Over the middle, complete. It's Hines. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down. This one down near the 20-yard line. And that one results in 35 yards. And now a first down following that long gain. His throw caught at about the 5. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling. This offense can certainly move quickly when they want to. 3 plays, 3 pass completions. In the blink of an eye, they've got a first and goal.
Almost felt like a lightning bolt hit in this game, didn't it? For them to get downfield that quickly. And now first and goal. Expect them to attack right here on this play.
Back now here on EA Sports. It's the Cowboys in possession of the football, but they trail here as we begin the fourth quarter of play. 2 big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. They come out with 1 back and 3 tight ends. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 5 yards, a good run there, and now 2nd and goal. When we talk about being on schedule, I think they're on schedule after that run, getting it right down there on the doorstep.
Maybe even a little bit ahead, because now the defense can't dictate with pressure. They're guessing about where you're going to go. I might come right back at them with the same play, the same set, and see if they can stop them.
They got to have 6 here. It's 3rd and goal. And they'll let their fullback try and push the pile. And he will take it in for a Cowboy score. Andy Janovich taking it in. And the Cowboys get a bit closer. All right, now a big 2-point conversion attempt still to come.
Here we go now.
They'll look to throw. And now another turnover as this one's intercepted. Picked off down at the 2. He's at the 50, the 40, past the 20, 10, 5, and he takes it all the way back. It's a pick 2, if you will, as head play backfires in a big way. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Onto the field now come the Bears. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had the field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for 3, except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, hey, let's get 3, right?
Not one that I've ever met.
First down and 10 now for the offensive group.
All right, here we go. Back to the Philly. Back Leopard.
We're looking for his tight end on the corner. It's complete. A really nice gain of 25 yards. But we haven't been shortchanged on offense. Another fun play to watch there on the deep pass.
This game has the feel of, what, a turkey bowl, a Thanksgiving day. You know, when we get together this year and the Davises and the Gardens get together, that's what our playbook's going to look like they're drawing them up in the dirt. And so far, it's working for both of them.
And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15, just shy of the 10. A big hitter there, a first down gain of 26 yards.
Well, it is our business to analyze what we saw out there. And on that play, I saw a defense staying in base, not taking a chance, not blitzing in a situation when they absolutely need the football back. That's either a case of overthinking it or not thinking it through.
If you do blitz, do you have to be careful about where you're coming from, or are you just coming from all angles?
You have to be careful about where you're coming from, obviously. But at this stage, you have to take a few chances as well.
See if they stay on the ground for second down.
All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56. Back in the NFL. Here we go.
And he fires one incomplete.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. The Bears on third down. They've had their troubles, just 1 for 6. This is 3rd and 9. And he is in. Touchdown, Chicago. They had the lead in the fourth, but still passing. Finding the big target for the touchdown. Now that lead grows even more.
Everybody gets to join in the fun. You know, it doesn't have to just be the wide receivers catching touchdown passes. The tight end doesn't just have to do just the dirty work inside. He gets a chance to get into the end zone as well.
The punter, Kaser, now out to kick it away. This is taken just shy of the 10 here. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Now a play fake here on first down. He's got his man on the crossing route. And he goes out of bounds across the 40-yard line. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue. Fresh set of downs here. There jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
It's a lot of contact going on there, and in the end, unable to keep two hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish. Second down following the incompletion. Back to the line of scrimmage. That's it. No gain on that one as it brings up a 3rd and 10. The Cowboys on third down. They've been good. 3 for 4 thus far. This is 3rd and 10. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. Give him 2 yards on that play, and that's going to bring up a 4th down. A critical one here if they're going to have any shot at this thing. So they'll go for it on 4th down. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. And he's got it. Got his man on the end route. Complete. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. That'll be a gain of 16. And on 4th down, they're able to convert and move the sticks. They'll look to throw here on 1st down. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
That's very well timed there defensively because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. Now he'll look to throw here on 2nd and 10. And he's going to be sacked. They sack him back right at the midfield stripe. And I know it seems like we say this a lot in broadcast booths, but a quarterback can hold on to the football too long in these situations. I think he did right there.
Oh, I agree with you totally. Sometimes you have to understand situations. Get rid of the football, save some yardage, and make it less to gain for the next down. Instead, he was so hipped on ball security, he held on to it and took a big sack.
Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw. Try to lay one up deep. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
I remember a coach telling me a long time ago the difference between playing corner and safety in the NFL. Corner is like the Autobahn. Everybody just flying by, and these corners have been really busy in this game, although they got it done on the last play.
On the last play, yes, but there have been some good numbers put up against them offensively. And the punter's on the sideline. Here's the field goal unit now to try an exceptionally long one. Now on fourth down, we've got a whistle here and a timeout. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. They're already slim hopes are going to ride on this one. They'll go on fourth down. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. The Cowboys here unable to convert on fourth down. And it'll be a turnover on downs. Well, their first fourth down attempt earlier was successful. This one backfires for a turnover on downs.
I like their aggressiveness. I like what they're doing. They got it the first time they went for it. Why not a second time? I don't think they'll be daunted from attempting it again. If you're on the defensive side of the ball, though, any fourth down stop is a big momentum play.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and four.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
No time to shine. Now they try the right side here. And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. At 5 yards on the play there as the drive will continue.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
A handoff as they run the counter play. And he went nowhere. Well, he went backwards, back to the 33. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Now a handoff looking right. And he'll get down to about the 26-yard line. And now the Cowboys are going to call another timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. The Bears on third down, lacking much success, just 2 for 7 to this point. This is third and 7. They'll look to throw. And he takes this one in for a Bears touchdown.
You have fun with this one, partner?
I am. He's been fun to watch under center.
We always talk about, you know, getting to the next level, right? When we see people get into the zone. This guy's in the master class right now. What a performance he's putting on, just carving him up.
4 touchdown passes, carving him up is right. Seems like everything he throws is going to be a completion and going in the end zone. The punter, Kazer, now out to kick it away. This will be taken about the 12. And he nearly broke that for more, but as it is, they'll start this drive at about the 37-yard line. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride?
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them.
Well, he did almost everything right. Excellent coverage, breaks on the football, just unable to haul it in and take it the other way. So he dropped an interception. The key for him now, don't dwell on it. Just move on to the next play.
Back to throw now on 2nd and 10. Pressure, and he's taken down. A Bears sack.
Partner, I know the ball security's preached like crazy, but every now and then, you've got to know when to get rid of the football and save a little bit of yardage if you're a quarterback.
Because now, if you're the offensive coordinator, what does it do if it was 3rd and 10 versus 3rd and much longer as it is now?
Yeah, it changes everything in terms of play calling and the pressure you might expect to face on the very next down. Had to throw the ball away and save the yardage. He didn't get it done.
Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Hines. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. And they have secured a spot in the conference championship, and now you can start to smell it at this point in the season, can't you?
You really can, because the focus has been one game at a time, not looking ahead. But when you get to the conference championship game and you know you're there,
the Super Bowl does loom in the future.